Google Sheets has a time function, and what it does is it takes three numbers and it converts them to a time that's usable in a spreadsheet. And the actual function itself isn't that complicated, but it gets a little bit tricky with what you can put into it and how the time comes out. So we'll just hit the equals button and I will type time. And then it needs the hour, the minute, and the second. So those are three inputs. All three of them need to be valid numbers. And that's what we have here. So we have the 13th hour. We'll select that. 25th minute and 48th second. So one thing you might be wondering about already is the hour is 13. So obviously there's 12 a.m., 12 p.m. We'll see how it's going to display that. We'll hit the equal sign. And it takes the 13th hour, rolls it over into 1 p.m. And it displayed this right, so it guessed correctly. The output from the time function isn't always formatted right, so we're going to take this function and we're going to put it into these next two cells, and then we'll show some other things that can happen. So another type of formatting that you can do with this, we'll go to number, we'll come down to the date and time formatting. It could come out with a date and a time, and this is a little bit confusing if you were to see this. Days start to be counting in spreadsheets at 12, 30, 18, 99. That's day zero. So all that's saying is there is no day on this. And then the last way to look at this, which I think helps you understand what times really are, is when you go to format and number again. If you just change it to a number and not a date, it's just a decimal. So 0.56 means that 1:25 p.m. is 56 one-hundredths of the way through the day. Okay, and so this is a longer decimal. If you want to show more decimals, they'll just keep going. And when you do math with times, it's actually using these decimal numbers. All right, so we'll move on, talk about some other things with it, and we'll circle back to actually doing a little bit of math with the times. And our next example, so I'm grabbing these from a template that you can find online at sheetshelp.com/time. That's all about this function. And you can follow along. We will grab this one. And this example is going to show you what happens. It's actually the same inputs, but the minute is just a 25.1. And if you look at the time now, before I hit enter, it's 1:25:48, right? But I'm changing the minute value. I hit enter, and it doesn't change the time. So that's one of the weird things that happens with the time function is that it truncates any decimals that you use as inputs. So 25.1 in this case is equal to 25. Same thing would happen with 25.9. So you can get what you feel like is an inaccurate result, but you just have to know that it's truncating the decimals. So we'll change that back to 25. So we're only doing one thing at a time. And the next thing that it can do is that, so the value of the seconds can be as low as zero or as high as 59 to really make sense in an output, but they can be higher. So let's put this at 59. So you have 1:25:59. If you go to 60, it just rolls over into the next minute. Okay, so it can be, let's say 6,000, 60,000, and it will just figure out that many seconds and roll it into the time. So that just shows you that the function can accept values higher than 0 to 59. If you put a negative value in here, that works too. It just rolls the time backwards. All right, so enough of playing with the inputs. Let's just use this, grab these two times, and we'll just use the time function in a formula, and we'll talk a little bit about why that's actually its most common use. We'll get rid of these, clear the formatting to make sure everything's okay. And let's say you want to subtract one time from another. So the result would be a duration, right? If you start something at noon and you work through to 2 p.m., it's 2 hours, but that's not 2 a.m. or 2 p.m., it's just 2 hours. So we'll go through how to do this here, and we'll start at, what is this, 3:19 p.m. And if you just typed in 3:19:47, and you then subtracted 1:25:48 and hit enter, it doesn't work. So that's a big reason for this time function is that it's a way to actually get times into formulas reliably What you could do, though, that typically works is to surround the time values in quotes. So we'll do that. And that worked. If you format that as a time, no, if you format that as, not as a time, as a duration, it's just under 2 hours. Okay, so that's working. But if you have these values already in your spreadsheet, using the time function is a very reliable way to get them in because it always produces a valid time. So we'll say this first time. Minus the second time value, so the difference between the two of them. Is 1 hour, 53 minutes. So when you need to take three numbers, turn them into a time and put them into another formula, time function's a way to do it. All right, now we're going to look at the sister function to time, if you will. It's called date. And if you didn't guess it already, it takes a year, a month, a day, and turns that into a valid day. I'll see you in that video. Thanks for watching.